Before I joined DeepMind, I did my doctorate here in Oxford. Students and academics at the University of Oxford and all other universities learn about knowledge and discoveries we as humanity have made so far. In their research, they build on this knowledge, evaluate new hypotheses, and make new discoveries that advance our understanding of the world. From discovering gravity to developing vaccines, outputs of this research, all this knowledge and experience is communicated through language. We also use language to communicate news about world events, opinions, or fictional imagined worlds and stories. The Bodleian Libraries here in Oxford contains more than 13 million of such items, and it would take one person nearly 10,000 years to read everything. This is a tremendous amount of knowledge human intelligence has created. Computers and artificial agents are much faster and often better than humans at many tasks. They're much faster at simple arithmetic, and they're much better at playing complex games like chess or Go. What if an artificially intelligent agent could learn to understand language and knowledge to the same level as humans? Imagine that instead of having to read everything, you could ask this intelligent agent to answer questions about all his knowledge, or summarize all articles about a particular topic, ask it to create personalized curricula so that we can learn faster, or debate things to help us make better decisions aligned with our values. What if the agent was able to make new logical arguments following from this knowledge, leading to new knowledge? What if it could collaborate with us on our research, suggesting new hypotheses, analyzing our data, or helping us simulate the impact of our policies on the world? I think such an intelligent agent would be really useful. Today, I want to talk to you about the surprisingly fast progress the field of AI has made in building an agent that understands language, and which may one day lead us to being able to build such an intelligent agent. During my studies, more than 8 years ago, I was working on teaching an agent to read and understand news articles and answer fill-in-the-blank questions about them. This is something an intelligent agent that can give us access to all our knowledge would need to be able to, and it is a task that was difficult at the time. We wanted to teach the agent to learn this task without telling it explicitly how grammar works or what the individual words mean, because that's difficult to explain to a computer program precisely. Instead, we provided the agent with many examples of questions, articles, and correct answers as training data, and we wanted it to learn language on its own. We implemented the agent as a neural network where all words in the article and the question were represented by vectors of numbers, basically lists of numbers. And then this network combines these word vectors into vectors which we hope will represent the meaning of phrases and larger parts of the article. Then it computes the probability for each word in our vocabulary whether it might be the correct answer. At the beginning, all these vectors are random, and this agent is just guessing randomly what might the answer be. Using a technique called machine learning, we can gradually adjust these vectors to make the probability of the correct answer higher on the training data. When people read text and when we don't know a word, we can often guess its meaning based on its context. And similarly, this agent is learning something about the words based on their context, but for all words at the same time. After training, this agent was able to answer new questions it hadn't seen before, and I was quite excited about this because it had learned to understand language a little. Since then, during the last 8 years, a string of discoveries has led to a significant leap forward. Researchers developed new foundation models called large language models that can power our agents. The agent I just showed you was able to learn one task from hundreds of thousands of examples. A large language model, on the other hand, is able to learn a new task from just a handful of examples, and that just by reading them, similarly to how humans can learn from just a handful of examples. If we provide it with two questions and two correct answers, and then a new question, it is able to continue this text by answering. These models can also learn from just a few examples many other tasks, such as how to tell which word a pronoun refers to, or how to choose a plausible completion to a story, or how to generate a story, for example, a short news article from just a title. And they can do this surprisingly well, they can generate convincing text so well that most of the time, human evaluators are unable to differentiate if the article was human-written or artificially generated. This may sound scary, but there is much work in the AI community on deploying these agents safely. They can also answer questions learners must answer while studying STEM, humanities, or social science, or answer simple logical reasoning questions like, did Aristotle use a laptop? In fact, they can do more than 150 language tasks, with new ones being discovered every day. So what are the key improvements that allowed us to build such a versatile foundation model? First, the question answering agent that I told you about at the beginning is learning something about the meaning of the words and phrases because it happens to be useful for its task of answering questions. A large language model is learning language in a similar way, but using a simpler task. It learns by predicting the next word in a sentence. For any sentence, such as the cat sat on the, it tries to predict the most likely next word, in this case, mat. The key difference is that before it was costly collecting all the training data with correct answers, but for this task, we can have basically limitless training data because we simply need text, and there is a lot of text on the internet. Second, a new architecture is used for the neural network called the transformer. Transformers, instead of iteratively reading the text word by word, they try to understand the meaning of the text at each word by relating it to all other words and phrases that came before. They use a mechanism called self-attention and then do this in multiple layers before predicting the next word. This architecture runs easier in parallel, so it is much faster and more efficient on our latest hardware. The third improvement is scale. We are building models that have 10 to 30 times more connections than 3 years ago, and which is 9,000 times more than the question answering agent I built during my studies. This gives the agent a lot more capacity to learn language and memorize knowledge. And the scale is important. For some tasks, like answering trivia questions, the small model is able to do this task a little, and with scale, it gets better. For other tasks, like detecting logical fallacies or detecting metaphors, the small model is just guessing randomly. And with scale, the capability to do these tasks emerges. We don't fully understand this phenomenon yet, but it makes you wonder, what other capabilities might emerge as we scale our models? So, next word prediction and abundance of data, the new transformer architecture that fits our hardware better, and scale is what allowed us to build these new foundation models. Let's look at some of the things they can do and some of the challenges that remain. A large language model can power an agent that will have a conversation with us. To do this, we provided with some framing. This is a conversation between a highly intelligent and knowledgeable AI assistant called AI agent and a human user called user. And then we provided with several conversation lines as examples. And the agent is able to continue this conversation by predicting the next word that fits this prompt, and it happens to answer to the user's questions. We can, for example, ask it to write an ad for a hat in the style of Shakespeare. And the agent writes, "Behold, a hat fit for a king or a queen," and so on. You would usually not see this framing, only the lines you write. We can also ask it to write a short TED talk mentioning the given bullet points, and it is able to write convincing, fluent, well-structured text mentioning all the points and expanding on them. And I wish I had thought of this before writing my talk. We can also ask it to write an article reporting about this event after it happened. However, in this case, since the agent was trained on training data from the internet until 2021, it doesn't have all the details. And unfortunately, instead of asking us for more information, it makes things up. For example, the date of the event. Let's ask a simpler factual question. When did the Apollo 18 mission land back on Earth? And the agent responds, December 1972. Is this correct? How would you try to verify whether the agent's response is true? You might try to check Wikipedia, assuming that it's often correct. Or you might try to talk to the people involved in these missions, or people who know them. This answer is actually not accurate. If we ask the same agent the same question, but in a different context, it gives us the correct answer. This agent was trained to predict the most likely next words, so it might not be factual. And the agent also can't interact in the world like we can, so it can't accurately talk about what is true or not, what we know only with some certainty, or what we don't know. Despite this, these agents are able to answer many factual questions correctly. And this is probably because the training data from the internet contains this factual information frequently. Thinking about an intelligent agent that can give us access to all our knowledge, in addition to knowing about some trustworthy sources, it needs to be able to have a solid reasoning ability to judge other sources. For example, when it's reading Harry Potter, it needs to know whether it's fact or fiction. And moreover, it needs to be able to reason to deduce new facts. There is some promising progress on improving reasoning of these agents, for example, for math word problems, by using this language model in a clever way. If we demonstrate to the agent thinking step by step, here in light blue, it will also try to do that. Highlighted in green, the agent writes out the equation it uses to arrive at an answer, and it answers correctly this time. And in fact, by using this chain of thought prompting, the agent is able to answer more questions correctly than before. And since these agents are still powered by large language models and trained to predict the most likely next word, they can still be inaccurate, use discriminatory language, or encourage unsafe behaviors. We would really prefer that the agents we build follow some rules, such as staying on topic, not making things up, and crucially, not using harmful language like insults or stereotypes. Explaining these rules to the agent is difficult because they require a lot of nuance. One strategy, how to teach the agent to follow these rules, is to have human annotators have conversations with the large language model, sometimes even try to make it break the rules, and subsequently rate its responses to collect good and bad examples of following these rules. Then using a technique called reinforcement learning, the agent can learn from these good and bad examples how to follow these rules better. This is also how the latest AI chat agents that you can try online are aligned with human preferences. And this agent is also able to follow the rule of not offering medical advice. If you tell it your symptoms, it will tell you to talk to a doctor instead, because that's safer. Our understanding of the world advances every day at an incredible pace. Keeping up with all the research articles and information published is practically impossible. But what if there's an insight in our libraries or in all the research published that could get us a step closer to better vaccines or solving the environmental challenges we face? And what if an intelligent agent could help us access that insight? Our agents went from having difficulty answering simple fill-in-the-blank questions to being able to do more than 150 language tasks, to being better aligned with our preferences, and to actually being able to read as much text as you can find in the libraries in Oxford. All this in just the last 8 years. Imagine where we could get in another 8 years. Imagine all the discoveries intelligent agents could help us make by providing a window to all this knowledge. Thank you.